Hi there and welcome to episode 233 of the ProBlogger podcast. My name's Darren Rouse and I'm the blogger behind ProBlogger.com, a blog, podcast, event, job board, series of ebooks and courses all designed to help you as a blogger to grow your blog, to get that blog started, but also to grow it and to build profit around your blog as well. You can learn more about ProBlogger at ProBlogger.com. Now, in today's episode, I want to introduce you to a suite of WordPress plugins, tools that we've been using on my blogs over the last 6 or so months, and that we will be investing more and more time into using more of in the coming year ahead. We're very excited about these particular tools, and I've brought my general manager, Lainey Galligan, on to talk about those tools. And I want to talk about those in a minute. But before I do want to mention that today's show is brought to you not by an external sponsor, but by our brand new courses at ProBlogger. And yes, you heard me right, courses. I've been talking about one of them now for about a month, our Ultimate Guide to Starting a Blog, and it has been going so well. We've had over 1,000 people start the course already. There's another 1,000 or so who've already registered in addition to that who are yet to start the course. But what's really exciting me is we're starting now to see blogs launched as a result of this particular course. And we've got a little Facebook group where we're celebrating the launches of the new blogs. And it is so exciting to see these brand new blogs come out the other end of the course. And we're getting some great reviews of the course as well. So please head over to ProBlogger.com/start-a-blog if you are interested in that particular course, starting a new blog. Now, I will say that you have a little bit of motivation to start your blog in the next couple of weeks, because on the 7th of February, we have ProBlogger's first ever International Starter Blog Day. It sounds grand. It's probably going to be a little bit less grand than that, but we want to have this day on the 7th of February where we celebrate all the blogs that are launched as a result of the course. And it already looks like there's going to be maybe 100 or so of them. So if you want to be included in our International Starter Blog Day and be listed on ProBlogger and hopefully get a few new readers, you need to register for the course by the end of January, 31st of January, and launch your blog by the 7th of February. So that's just to give you a little bit of extra motivation to get that blog you've been thinking about launching up and ready. So that's the starter blog course, but we've also got this second course because we've been asked by so many people as we have been promoting this starter blog course, is there a course for people who've already got a blog? The starter blog course is about getting the blog started. It's not really relevant for those of you who've already got a blog. So we do have another course coming in March. We've actually already almost completed it. It's going to be our 31 Days to Build a Better Blog course. Now, long-time listeners will be familiar with that name. I originally ran 31 Days to Build a Better Blog in 2007 or 2009. I can't remember. I always get those mixed up. But I've done it as a series of blog posts, which I updated 2 years after I did it the first time. We then turned it into an ebook, which I then updated in 2012. So there's two versions of the ebook. We sold that ebook to tens of thousands of people. So I know many of you have done that particular ebook, and you know that it's relevant for new bloggers, but also those of you who've been around for a while. The whole idea of 31 Days to Build a Better Blog is that it's got teaching but also practical things to do. And that's really what both of these courses are about. They give you homework, they give you little exercises to do that take you a step closer to your goal. And so what we've done with 31 Days to Build a Better Blog is we've taken all of the blog post series, all of the podcasts, all of the ebooks that I've done, and we've updated it all, and we are launching our new version of 31 Days to Build a Better Blog as a course. And that will go live in March. So if you are interested in taking that course, it's a paid course, but we are keeping it as affordable as we can, and we're actually even launching it with a further discount as well for people who pre-register. Just head to ProBlogger.com/31 days, and that will forward you to where you can register your interest in the course, and you'll also be able to see a full outline of the course as well. Okay, you can find links to both of these courses as well as a transcript of today's show and links to the tool that we're talking about at our show notes at ProBlogger.com/podcast/233. All right, thanks for listening to all that. I'm going to get into the show today. I've got a little bit to say about the tools, and then we'll get into a bit of an interview that I did with Lainey.
Creating great content. Finding an audience. Building engagement. Monetizing your blog. This is ProBlogger.
Okay, so on to the topic of today's episode. I want to introduce you to this suite of tools, WordPress plugins, that we've been using on the ProBlogger and Digital Photography School for the last 6 or so months now, and we are so excited about them. The tools are from Thrive Themes. Now, you might be familiar with Thrive Themes. They're WordPress themes. They're very good themes. We've recommended them in the past, but over the last year or so, they've also been developing a series of 9 or so plugins that are just fantastic, and every time they add a new plugin, we get really excited at ProBlogger headquarters. Now, I'm not going to go through them all right now because we do so in the rest of this show, but these are all plugins that are particularly relevant for anyone wanting to build a business around their blog. They'll help you grow your email list, so convert your readers into subscribers. They'll help you to then convert those subscribers into customers by helping you design landing pages and customize the look of your pages and blog posts as well. Very cool tools. And the other thing I love about these tools, and I do mention it in the show notes, is that they're incredibly affordable in comparison to some of the other tools that are out there. Some of the other tools that we've used in the past, we've actually switched from them to Thrive because, one, they're more affordable, and two, they work so intuitively. Now, you can find all of these tools if you head to ProBlogger.com/Thrive. ProBlogger.com/Thrive. And I do recommend you, as you listen to the show, that you go and actually have a look because there are features listed there that we simply don't have time to get into in today's show. The last thing I will say before I get into the interview that I did with Lainey earlier today is that I want to really disclose up front that I am an affiliate for Thrive, but we're also a paying customer. They haven't given us this for free. We pay for it and we get so much value out of it. And as a result, I'm really comfortable promoting it as an affiliate. That link, ProBlogger.com/Thrive, does earn me a small commission if you make a purchase. It doesn't cost you anything more, but it helps me to keep producing these free podcasts. So I do appreciate it. If you find these tools suited to your needs, head over to ProBlogger.com/Thrive and make your purchase as a result of clicking through on that link. It does help us to keep ProBlogger going. Okay, I've talked too much today already, so I'm going to now get into this interview I did with General Manager of ProBlogger Lainey Galligan. I asked her to come on and talk to me about Thrive because she is a massive fan of it and has loads more hands-on experience with it than I have. And so I thought she'd be perfect to talk about it. So this is an interview I did with her earlier today. It goes for about an hour, so you may want to make yourself comfortable, but do open up that link, ProBlogger.com/Thrive, as you listen, and you'll be able to follow through the 9 or so plugins as we go through them. Thanks for listening, and I'll chat to you at the end of this chat that I had with Lainey. Hi, Lainey, how are you today?
I'm pretty good, Darren. I'm pleased to have you back from holiday.
It is good, and I'll be very happy when school holidays finish, but that's a whole other story for today. We are Lego City all over our house at the moment. It's been a bit crazy, but we want to talk today about a suite of tools that we've been using on ProBlogger Digital Photography School for the last 12 months, and I thought rather than me talking about it, I'd get you in because as General Manager of ProBlogger and Digital Photography School, you've got very hands-on experience with setting up and using this tool from Thrive Themes. We had a conversation about another tool last year in episode 195 on co-schedule, and that was so popular, I thought I'd get you back again to talk about Thrive Themes. So welcome back.
Thank you very much. It's good to be here, and I like talking about these different tools because they make my life easier. So yeah, it's all good.
You're the queen of tools, I think.
I think so.
That could be interpreted two ways. But anyway, maybe if you can talk to us a little bit about Thrive. What is this tool? Well, it's a suite of tools, really. So maybe if you could talk us through a little bit about what is Thrive Themes membership tools.
Yeah, sure. So I guess most people might be familiar with Thrive themes themselves, so actual themes for your WordPress site, and maybe also Thrive leads is something that people have heard about before for opt-ins and email signups. But it really is, it's a suite of a number of different WordPress plugins, and the company is very focused on like conversion-based plugins, so solutions to help you really convert your audience and give them a good experience on your blog or on your website. They've developed a whole range of plugins, not a huge number. I think there's about 9 or so. And you can, you know, use the plugins individually, but you can also access all of them with a membership, which is what we do. So there's, about 9 plugins and then the membership, so you can access all of them.
So we'll probably focus most of our conversation on the plugins that we use, but maybe before we dig in deep into those, maybe we should just run through the plugins in the suite, which may pique some interest of our listeners.
Yeah, sure, because they do have plugins that help you design your blog, build landing pages, generate leads, increase conversions. So the first one, which is one that they've just upgraded recently, is a drag and drop editor called Thrive Architect, and that enables you to create landing pages really intuitively. It's one of my favorites, has changed my life when it comes to doing things on the fly for both sites, but also allows you to add elements, like really neat elements, to your individual blog posts as well, so it's not just about landing pages.
I love that it can be used in the blog post itself, because you can really take a normal blog post and almost create a complete custom design for it.
Looks you can. Amazing. Yes. Thrive Leads is for all of your opt-ins and sign-up forms, and it is very, very clever. We'll talk about that a bit more, because that's one of the second ones that we're using most often at the moment. Thrive Ovation, when I saw this one, I just thought that is super clever. So it allows you to collect testimonials from multiple sources. So you can set up a landing page with a form and say, look, could you please leave me a testimonial? Or you can import comments that are made on social media, so for example, Facebook, or comments on your blog and other ways as well, that you can get those really valuable testimonials and comments and things that people are saying about you, and pulling them into a format which then allows you to just drag and drop it onto your landing page if you're using something like Thrive Architect, which is just, you know, when you're doing a sales page and you just think, I've got to get a testimonial. Where do I find one? How do I make it look good? Oh, I don't have their photo. What should I use? So Thrive Ovation actually helps you manage that whole process, so that it makes it really easy to get those all-important testimonials onto your landing pages.
Very clever.
It is super clever, and we're in the process of setting it up at the moment for a couple of our courses, both for ProBlogger and also for Digital Photography School as well, and I can't wait to see those in action.
One's Ultimatum there.
Yeah, yep. Ultimatum is, again, another really super clever solution from Thrive. It allows you to create countdown campaigns. So if you've got, for example, a limited time offer or a sale or a special on, it's the thing that you would normally see where your little countdown sort of pops up from the bottom of your site and says, hey, you know, this special offer is available for X more days or hours. So most people are sort of aware of the whole countdown timer thing. We use it, obviously, for our Christmas sale at the end of each year. We didn't use this particular one because we have one coded already, but this does give you a lot more flexibility. So you can do it for like a set time special offer, but you can also do it, and this is where it's really clever, for an individual. So if somebody comes to your site and does something, you can then have an interaction with them, whether it might be they sign up and then you send them to the landing page or a thank you page. You can then actually offer them a personalized offer of some description. So whether it be like, hey, you know, thanks for downloading our guide, our ultimate guide. We hope you find it useful. If you'd like to take the next step, here's, you know, $10 off our next beginner book available to you for the next X amount of time. So it gives them a personalized countdown offer, which is really, I guess, helping people to convert based on that sort of idea of scarcity. But I like this because it is real scarcity. They come along and you've given them an opportunity to take advantage of an offer, and you cannot crack that. It doesn't reset and just start again. So it's actually real scarcity. So the plugin's that clever. It knows if they reset their cookies or try and access it on a different device. It's got like a lockdown feature on it, so that it is a true one-time offer for that countdown for that person.
So they'll come back a couple of days later, and if the countdown's finished, it's finished. If it's still got a little bit to go, it picks up where it should pick up.
Exactly,
so it's
right.
Quite smart.
Yes, it is. And it'll say, look, sorry you missed out, we'll send you here instead, or something along those lines as well. So you've got all of that flexibility with that particular plugin. So it's quite clever. The headline optimizer is one that I haven't really had much of a look at, mainly because I just think, well, I'll just use CoSchedule. It tells me a score for my headlines and whether they're any good or not. But this is like one step up from that, and that it actually allows you to put in multiple number of headlines for the same blog post, and it'll split test them all for you live. So depending on who comes to look at it, it'll give them a different headline. And if they interact with that headline, it'll know and it'll count against your traffic. And you'll actually get like actual engagement-based results in your split testing rather than, oh, hey, this one was shared this number of times on social media, so it's obviously the better result. So it doesn't get skewed by whether one really big social media account shares something for you. It's actually based on the results of how they actually came to the site and interacted on your actual website. So one that I'm actually interested in having a look at, but there's only so many things you can try out at once, but it looks super clever from that perspective.
I had a look before, and some of the metrics it looks at is how long people stay on your site, how far they scroll down the site, whether they click through on a call to action. So it's looking at all those metrics and then determining which version of the blog post with the different headlines wins, and then it automatically selects the best one, which is pretty cool. And there are, you know, sites like BuzzFeed have complicated tools that do this for them. So this is a way of playing with that in a fairly affordable way.
Oh, absolutely. It's some of these plugins, they're like the BMW of plugins. They're very, very intelligent. And some of the engineering behind them, I think, is so clever. Speaking of clever, the next one is Clever Widgets. And this is something I remember, I'm sure I've asked Mario before. I'm just like, Mario, I want to put this widget in this area, but I only want it to show when it is on these pages or people are looking at this category or whatever. How do we do that? And what I'm really asking for is like conditional widgets. Only show it in this space on the side, or only put it in the sidebar for this category or for these pages or whatever it may be. So Clever Widgets allows you just upload it. And then whenever you go to your widget areas and you want to drag something in, you can then have a separate option which just says, yep, make this conditional and only show it here.
On our photography blog, we could have a Photoshop course that we want to advertise, but only show it when people are looking at a Photoshop article, whether it's based on categories or tags, which is
exactly
really clever.
Right. Yep, and it operates on any of your widget areas, not just your sidebar, but if you've got, you know, an after content widget area or, you know, your banner at the top or however you want to do it, whatever your theme has, it'll give you that option. Only show it when this occurs.
You're listening to ProBlogger.
Yeah, they have themes. So obviously I mentioned that and people might be more familiar, and that's where the name originally came from, Thrive Themes. They have 10 conversion-focused WordPress themes. And again, they're super slick. They're built for speed. They're built for conversion. They have things built into them so that you don't have to have extra plugins to do things on the site. They've got really great templates for pages and just makes everything streamlined and really quick. I haven't used them yet, so I can't talk about them to a great extent, but I do love the fact that they use some of the same sort of editing styles that Thrive Architect uses as well. Mm-hmm. And obviously they integrate perfectly with Thrive Architect, Thrive Leads, and all of the other widgets in Thrive as well to just make a really smart website.
And they've got Quiz Builder.
Quiz Builder, yeah, I can't wait to have a play with this one. Quiz Builder is exactly that. It allows you to build a quiz. So when you see, for example, on, I guess, Facebook, they'll just say, you know, what kind of, you know, such and such are you? It's that kind of thing. You can build a quiz and have people answer questions and then obviously give them a result at the end. Probably a really good one for helping people navigate around your site or around your content. So for example, with photography, it could be, you know, like, you know, what kind of photography or where should I start or what kind of photography course should I do? Or with blogging as well, it's like, where are you at? You know, so are you just at the beginning or are you just needing a bit of a zhuzh up of your, you know, your old blog, or, you know, are you ready to make some money and those sorts of things? So you can use it for almost anything. You can include videos in it and then have at the end of it, obviously, a customized pathway for your reader to take. And, you know, you can build offers and all those sorts of things into it as well based on the answers that they give you.
I think it's really smart in that, I mean, you could just use this to get engagement from your readers, and that in itself is a great thing because readers love taking quizzes and seeing their results and sharing their results. But I think being able to build it into almost like the entry into a funnel, you know, here's some further reading for you, here's a product that will be relevant for you, I think that makes a lot of sense.
Yes, yep, absolutely. And then comments is a new one that they've just brought out, and so it's not really something that I've had a chance to look at yet because it's not high on our list of needs for things that we need to work on. Mm-hmm. But they're just really working on just like clever ways of making comments sort of more engaging, easier for people to have conversations with each other as well. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, they think of everything. They test them out quite a lot. If you have a membership, you'll see that there's a couple of other things available within the membership which they are not selling out front yet, and they really just give their members the chance to do that first. Mm-hmm. So there's a really cool one which helps you do some simple sort of content protected courses on your website.
You know, even that comments one, I think it's really smart. They've taken what you see on Reddit. So you, in your comments, you can allow your readers to vote up someone else's comment to rate it. You can then feature that comment. There's just these smart little things that you could probably hack together with other plugins, but to be able to have them all in the one sort of suite of tools is really smart. So all of these you can, I think you can buy standalone, or then there's the option there to get them all with a membership as well. We might talk about that pricing towards the end of this episode. So maybe if we could just dive into the plugins that we're particularly using. So Thrive Leads, I think, was the first one that you wanted to talk about.
Yes, so Thrive Leads, we've been using this probably more consistently for about the last 6 months. I've started it off on ProBlogger first, and we replaced all of the signups on ProBlogger, and that was quite a process. Yeah. thanks for passing that one on to me. I inherited quite a lot of fun of going back through, I guess, you know, 8,000 posts worth of content on ProBlogger, trying to find all the little places you had managed to squirrel away a sign-up form.
You're welcome.
which was previously done directly using Aweber forms. Mm-hmm. So if anyone's familiar with the process with their own email provider, you generally get given some code and you can go and put that code somewhere on your site and voila, you've got a sign-up box and you just feel quite proud of yourself. But please, please, if you're going to do that, keep a register of where you put all those things because it does really make it hard to go through and change and update. So there are a number of different ways that we use to try and find everything. So we did a search in the database for the code, for the form code. I did searches for the words sign up, subscribe. You know, we check to make sure we captured all the thank you pages. It is quite a process to go through and find all of those touch points and next step points where we send people to in order to replace them all with new code. And so now I have set up a register to make future changes and updates a lot easier. And also because you're generally connecting something like Thrive leads to your email service provider. So the integration's there, and sometimes there's other integrations, and then sometimes you're then passing them through workflows or adding tags as well. So I actually write out that entire process now, so we've got a record of how we're using our different sign-up forms, because now we don't generally just use one general sign-up form. We like to be able to customize what we're offering people based on where they've come into our blog. So there are a number of different types of sign-up forms as well, and they're all giving us different information about what our readers are most interested in.
So Thrive Leads will let you collect emails in a variety of different types of forms. We've got your traditional pop-up, love or hate them, sticky ribbons, which are the little strip that goes across the top. You can put forms inside content, which we've been experimenting with quite a bit on Digital Photography School. Slide-ins, the big overlays that fill up the whole screen. I like the look of the one that I think it's called the content lock, where you can put content behind a sign-up so they can kind of see bits of the content, but to unlock it, they have to give you the email address. So it's all the normal types of sign-up forms, and as with many of the other tools, you can A/B test them as well, which we've done a bit of. Do you want to talk a little bit about that A/B testing we've done?
Yeah, for sure. So not only do you have all the different types of forms, you can choose to show them in different ways. So, for example, you can have what they call a lead group, and using lead groups allow us to customize what we show readers depending on the content that they're viewing. So, for example, if they're coming through onto podcast episodes, we show them different pop-ups than if they were coming through somewhere else, or if they're coming into either a podcast episode or a blog post that is from the starter blog category, we know that they're beginners and we'll show them something different to other parts of the site as well. And so lead groups allow you to do that really well, and it just means that you're not having to go and put code everywhere on your site. It actually just says, where do you want us to show this and how, and allows you to prioritize one group over another as well. So that's pretty cool. And then within those, you can then each of those groups of leads. So when it is a group, it might be a group might be something like show them a scroll map first, but then later on do a pop-up or have something further down on the page where they can also sign up. And you can start split testing any one of those forms, and you can also, and I haven't seen this anywhere else, split test different forms against each other. So split test to see how a full scroll mat sign up form compares to an in-content sign up form. And that's not something that I've seen before either. And people are always saying, oh, look, I hate those big scroll map things. But if you can show that they actually work and it works better than something else, then it's good to know that kind of thing, rather than just think, oh, am I making people mad? Well, do you know what? It's actually performing really, really well. So we have done some A/B testing on both ProBlogger and on DPS. And on DPS, we restyled the way that we offer one of our opt-ins, which are our regular ultimate guides, so quite a comprehensive download that we offer for free if you subscribe, and it had a very ugly, plain-looking opt-in form to be able to do that. And so I thought, well, we've got a nice new landing page. I'll create a lovely new lead form to go with that. And so, but I said, but well, let's also recreate the old one as well. So we had a pretty versus ugly, and ugly won. I'm like, really?
But it's always the way.
It's always the way. Ugly wins every time. Well, actually, ugly doesn't win every single time, but where it does, we're able to just show that so we can pick a winner. You can do that automatically. You can say, look, pick a winner automatically after it showed at least X number of times and, you know, the conversion is better than such and such. So you can get quite granular with how you decide to do that, or you can just do it manually and just check back in and go, yep, you know what, let's just end this and pick this one as the winner. So you've got options with those. Another one that we did was for ProBlogger, for one of our opt-ins there, and it tested whether or not it just showed the sign-up form, so a single-step sign-up process. So the sign-up form popped up and you asked for your email straight away, versus saying, I guess, a multi-step sign-up, which would be like, hey, this is what we're offering, you know, are you interested in it? And people can just say yes or no. And if they say yes, then you show them the sign-up form, and that's actually been shown to increase conversions because it's consistent with what they've already told you. They say, yes, they are interested in that, and then they go on to actually sign up. So for, I think, one or two of our opt-ins, the multi-step works better, or the other one, the single-step works better. So sometimes it's worth playing around with those just to see, whether or not they just need that one little bit step more rather than just like, oh, another pop-up form, and dismiss it. You're actually asking them if it's something they want or not, rather than just putting that sign-up form right in their face. And it's been nice to see how that works as well.
That's great, and gives you so much control as to the types of sign-ups you have. I know a lot of people really struggle with anything that interrupts the flow of readers, and so another one that they've got is what they call smart links. So in an article, you can make a subscribe to our newsletter a link rather than a form. So it's just a normal link, and if they click the link, then a form opens up as a result. So you do get the pop-up, but only when the person's asked for it to pop up. So it's perhaps a more polite way of doing it, which is something that I've heard converts very well, because anyone clicking that link has a high intent of actually taking action on what you're calling them to do.
Yeah, exactly right. So the same concept for sure. Yeah, so that's the Thrive Leads. And then, of course, we talked about some of the other things that we were looking at with Thrive Ovation and Ultimate and everything like that. But Leads is something which also integrates into sales pages as well. So with Thrive Architect, obviously they integrate really well with each other. So if you're creating a landing page, you can grab things like a lead generation box that you've already set up with Thrive Leads and pull it into the page and use different templates that you've already set up as well. So, but we've mainly been using Leads, and then Architect is to create all of our landing pages and make some of our blog posts, particularly on ProBlogger, look way more snazzier. We've been able to introduce some really cool elements and visual elements, like, you know, pop-out boxes and other like tables, which are really hard to do otherwise when you want to style your blog posts. So it just gives you more ability to choose sort of, I guess, colors of fonts and do other things that are over and above what your theme allows you to do. Just the way I've been able to just intuitively pick up how it works and create things on the fly really quickly. So for example, I think it was when you needed a landing page for your FinCon keynote.
Yep.
And you had an offer for people who came to your keynote. I was able to go to Thrive Leads and check out all of their templates that they had, and just pick something, customize it, whip it together, have a matching landing, a thank you page and a delivery page for the download. And it took no time at all and looked really good.
There are a lot of landing page creators out there, but I really haven't seen anything that allows you to customize a blog post. And this is something I think more and more bloggers need to be doing. If you've got a special series coming up, why not create a custom sort of theme just for that series? Do something really special to make it stand out to your readers. You can do that so easily within Thrive Architect as well.
How to build and monetize your blog. This is ProBlogger.
So you've come up with 10 top features. Before we talk about what you don't like about it, let's talk about the top 10 things that you do like about, some of which you've touched on already, if you want to take us through those.
Yeah, sure. So these first ones are to do with more of the design and editing functions. So Thrive Architect Editor works for creating your Thrive Leads forms, your sign-up forms, as well as for landing pages, as well as for, like you just said, the blog posts. And it is drag and drop It is super fast live editing, and this is like nothing I've actually seen before. It is actually true live editing. So you click on the element on the page, you're basically seeing a preview of what you're going to see, and you're just live editing it straight then. So you just click your cursor in and start doing stuff. You can drag and drop things around to move them, and there's no, you know, filling out fields on the side and then clicking refresh to see how it looks, which is, I think, I got quite excited about lead pages when I first saw it. And whilst we love, you know, Drip, who are associated with lead pages, I just couldn't persevere with lead pages because it was just a little bit frustrating and slow. And when I discovered Thrive Architect, well, we actually started using it when it was Thrive Content Builder, I just couldn't believe how much easier it was to just edit, move, and things were happening as I was, you know, I could see what I was doing in live time, which was really, really great. So that would be my top thing, the fact that this drag and drop is just, it's super quick and you're just live editing as you go. My second top feature with the editing is it's so easy to create margins and padding to position your elements. You will not believe how important this is to make it easy to get all your spacing right on a landing page. Previous software that I've used or previous plugins that I've used, you've kind of had to fudge it a little bit by putting an extra row or something like that in there. And it's just, it wasn't easy and you didn't always get the result that you were looking for. And with Thrive Architect, they've even improved the way that you do this. You can actually just go over to this little thing on your sidebar and just drag an arrow up or down to increase or decrease the number of pixels that you want in your margins, top, bottom, left, right. And it actually, you see the effect live as you go. So it's not like, oh, I think, wonder what 30 pixels would look like, type in 30 pixels and then wait to see what it looks like. You can actually just drag it and move it around, and it actually just shows you live. You can also enter the pixels as well, but it's just so easy to use. And it uses that same kind of features with things like font size. There's just a little thing that you can just grab and slide it backwards and forwards and see things happen straight away. Image sizes, same kind of stuff. So it just, it kind of puts it all there at your fingertips and makes you feel like you're a bit of an architect in it. I think it's brilliantly named just for that alone.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I've even used it, which is saying something. I'm not a designer, but I've found my way through it, and I created a couple of pages and was able to edit things that I think when you were away last time, I was able to fix a few things up and change things when we were changing our deals over. So it's really so easy to do once you know which button to click to get into it. It's so easy.
Yeah, and that was one of the big things, one of the big factors and why I said, look, we really need to do this, because it does make us less reliant on having to ask somebody. Like for Mario, he's created some really great custom themes and things for us for like sales pages and stuff, but you can't just change it. You know, it's hard coded, and you have to fill out this field and do this and do that, and they all have to kind of look the same. Whereas if you want to just make changes on the fly, or you just want to put an extra element in because that will actually really make sense for this particular product, for example, you can't do that as easily. But with Thrive Architect, like any one of us can do it, which is great. And like you said, even you can do it, which is awesome. So my job is done. That works really well. But one of the things that does make it really effective and turn anybody into a great designer is its templates. I started out saying how Thrive are very much conversion focused. They have a whole suite of templates that you can use for both your sign up forms and your landing pages. And it makes whipping something up super fast, like the FinCon landing page and sign up page and the download page, for example. And so there are actually families of templates, so that when you are setting up, I guess, a funnel, if you want to call it that, so where you go from here's my sales page or my opt-in page and here's my sign up form, and now you're on the thank you page, and then if you do this and click this, then you'll go to a download page. They have families of templates that are all in the same style, so that everything looks consistent. And they're already designed in a way that they know convert really well. So all you have to do is, you know, change an image, change the colors and the fonts to suit what your brand is, and it's done. Like, it's really, really, really easy. So that is my number three top 10 features, is those templates are worth their weight in gold.
It does help you create something that's more professional and consistent. There's nothing worse than a bitsy experience for your readers. You want them to feel like they're in something that all belongs together. So it makes a lot of sense.
Absolutely. Now, other than the templates themselves, there are actually lots of different design elements that you can select and edit. And one of my favourites is the different frames that you can select for, say, inserting a video onto a sales page. And I'll put a link in our show notes. We have a sales page that we did last year for a limited time promotion. And all the videos are in a desktop computer frame. So it looks like they're inside a Mac. And I looked, I'm like, that's really, really clever. So it's actually, you can do so much with it, and you can choose a different style of computer, or you can put it on a laptop, or you can put it on an iPad or something like that. And then you can change the size of it and just do all these amazing things. And there, your Vimeo or YouTube video, you just put the URL link into your sidebar and choose how you want it to look, and bang, there it goes.
So clean as well. You know, looking at that page now, it's a very easy read, the way that's all laid out.
Yeah, for sure. And that, again, I think that was one of Luke's first sales pages using Thrive Architect, and he did an amazing job, and it looks fabulous just because they're just so easy to use. Number five would be the content element template. So you might create, for example, we created a call out box with your head in it as a little icon to just have as like when you're talking on a page, for example, or you're giving a tip. And so once you set that box up as an element, you can actually save it as a template. So if you're creating another page, or I'm doing a blog post, for example, and I'm just like, oh, I want to call out here with a tip from Darren in it, I can just go insert and then just select, you know, tip box with Darren's head and pop it in. And there you go. You don't have to recreate anything. So you can save your own designs and elements as well, or you can export and import entire pages, sign up box designs, whatever you want. And use them again on different sales pages as well. So just being able to have that flexibility is awesome, because you're not having to recreate the wheel every time. And it does mean you move more towards that sort of consistent feel for your brand.
Mm, that's so useful. And I could see that in a blog post. You know, quite often you use different types of block quotes. You know, a lot of design themes would have one style there, but you could create, you know, a variety of different ones for different things, or, you know, featuring different types of content. So that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah, we've done them before with some blog posts where we're just like, do this, don't do this. So you've kind of got, you know, your ticks and your crosses and all those sorts of things. Any of those little things that you feel like you might use again because they're useful, you can save as an element and insert it into whatever you're doing. Great. And number six, this is really, really good and are so clever. It is super easy to achieve actual true responsiveness for whatever you're creating, whether it's your sign-up boxes or your landing pages or your blog posts. You can then further customize them so you get them looking exactly how you want them to look on tablets and mobile as well. So you can hide elements, you can change spacing, you can swap order of elements, and it kind of cascades down. So it'll say, this is what it looks on desktop, this is what it will look like on a tablet, and this is what it will look like on mobile. And so you can really make sure that whatever it is that you're trying to present, if it doesn't work on mobile, take that bit out and it won't impact the other views of your page or your sign-up box, for example. And you can also just toggle on whether you want your sign-up boxes to even show on mobile or not. So, again, heaps of flexibility in terms of achieving, I guess, the best viewing result for your reader, depending on how they're coming to your content.
That's so good. This is what a lot of top-end publishers are doing on their sites at the moment, is showing different things to different different devices, really, and to be able to do that is very powerful.
Oh, absolutely. You can even show – so, for example, if I started changing a heading in the mobile responsive view, that heading would also change on the desktop because you're making hard changes to the actual content that's on there. But if I changed, you know, the amount of space after the heading, that would only apply to the mobile version, for example. But then something else you can do is when you're creating the content in the desktop view, you can hide whole blocks of content and say, don't show this in mobile. Or only show this on mobile, for example. So again, heaps of flexibility in terms of what you show, exactly what you show your readers.
You're listening to ProBlogger.
So four more things from your top 10.
Yeah, four more things. These next three are more about, I guess, just the intelligence and the way it integrates with the other things that we use. So number seven, I guess I did touch on this already, but the different ways that you can serve a lead form on your site. So I talked about lead groups earlier. You can also choose to use short codes. Now, short codes, sometimes people just think, oh no, what if you stop using Thrive Leads or Thrive Architect or whatever, you're just going to get left with these short codes everywhere. They don't do that. So they don't leave your site littered with short codes. Just as an aside from this particular point, you will still get your content shown. It just won't be styled in the way that you styled it using their plugin. So that's one good thing to know. But you can put short codes in, which would have made things a lot easier to remove all the AWeber forms, because you could just turn off a short code and then it wouldn't show anymore. So that is one good thing about having short codes. So if you've got something inserted with a short code and you decide, like, right, we're not going to offer that anymore, or we're not going to use that sign up form anymore, you can actually turn it off from your dashboard rather than trying to go and remove all of the short codes. And another way is light boxes. So there are actually light boxes automatically generated if you want to use them, which is connected to your lead generation element that you might want to drag into a landing page as well. So there are multiple different ways that you can actually serve a lead form, and it just gives you more control over how they're viewed, where they're viewed, and allows you to keep an eye on things like conversion rates and all that sort of thing from one dashboard as well. So again, love how that works. Number eight is, again, the split A-B testing, which we talked about. So I think I've given the examples already of what we did with our ultimate guides and the pretty versus ugly. So all of those things are great. And I just think it's great being able to have that level of granularity when you're looking at, well, if we do this, will it actually be worthwhile for us? So the split A-B testing is pretty amazing, and I've been really happy with that.
And there's no point, you know, trying new things unless you can track how things are, how things work, really. You don't want to try the new pop-up or the new takeover scroll mat or any of these things unless you're able to prove that they're doing a better job than what you were doing previously. So, you know, it's such an important thing to actually use. And I know a lot of the tools do have that type of testing, but so many people don't use them. They just stick the pop-up up and then let it go. You can be constantly tweaking that to improve your results. Yeah.
And I think that's certainly when you get to a stage with your blogging and your content where you've established your content, you've established an audience, and you're starting to maybe sell things or promote things, this is when you want to start looking at these kinds of tools, because the difference in a few percentage in conversions and things like that can make a big difference. It can move the needle and really help you move forward with the growth of your business. And having these intelligent types of tools available to you just make that so much easier to make those decisions, because, you know, there's a lot of people out there who are running their blog on their own. So you really need to think about, well, what's the return on my effort on doing all of these things? You really want to know if that's worthwhile or not. So again, I love the intelligence of their solutions. Number nine is how easy it integrates. So we integrate with AWeber still, with Digital Photography School, via an API. So super fast. It's like, yep, connect it to AWeber and send everything to this list, tick a box, do this afterwards and add this tag if you want to. And it's just so simple. Mm-hmm. With ProBlogger, we've been using drip. So we're really trialing out drip for the company on the ProBlogger website first. Drip is amazing, and we'll talk about that in another episode, perhaps. Mm-hmm. But with drip, we actually do it via an HTML form. So we basically take the HTML form from the drip form that we generate via drip, and we then put that in, and it still allows us to connect it that way and say, yep, pass these tags back to drip. And it's pretty easy, just not quite as seamless as an API. And I'll tell you why we don't use the API with drip under the bits that I don't like so much.
Okay. And it integrates with, all. I'm just looking at it now. You've got ActiveCampaign, Campaign Monitor, Constant Contact, ConvertKit, GetResponse. They all sync with this tool. So I'd be surprised if listeners were using an email service provider that it doesn't integrate with.
Oh, absolutely. There really is no excuse to be putting, the HTML code to generate forms directly in your content, because remember, you're going to go and have to clean that up one day. Mm-hmm. Don't do it. Don't do it. And the 10th one is the team knowledge at Thrive. So the documentation and the support are really good. There's a comprehensive knowledge base with videos walking you through pretty much everything, tutorials. There's a forum. The one thing I will say about the forum is just do your homework first. I mean, most of the issues that I see in there are user error. And so you can pretty much search the issue that you're having, and you can find someone else who's done the same thing wrong and the answer from the team. So it's quite good. I've only had to use it a couple of times. There's a Thrive University, so there's actual little courses and things that you can go through. And it's not just about their products. It's just about, how to generate more leads and just general good marketing knowledge that they've put into a little university there. Some of those are exclusive to Thrive theme members only, but there are others that are not. And my favourite are their emails. So I reckon if they're running a lead score on me, I would have like the highest score ever, because I do open every single one of their emails and I go to the link that they tell me to go to, because I find gold, 9 times out of 10, I learn something useful pretty much every time, and I look forward to the emails that they send. And they put so much effort into their emails and creating new video tutorials and telling you how they've improved things, how you can use that. Even things like, hey, we created all these cool design elements. If you want to use them, this is how you get them and open them and save them and like customize them and save them into your own Thrive so that you can use them on your pages. And I'm like, great. Thank you very much. Mm-hmm. And they're really focused on what they do, and they do a great job of delivering it.
And the thing I love about them, as someone who isn't as hands-on as you, is just even their sales pages. You can see in their selling of their product how much they care about it, and they're not into hype. They're very matter-of-fact in the way that they talk and the way they sell what they do. It's very clear. All of the communication that I've ever seen is very clear. You're not guessing what they mean. There's something about this company that I just really respect, the way that they present themselves.
Yeah. Is that something to do with the bald guy who's just really friendly and matter of fact?
Well, bald guys do tend to.
I thought you might relate. Shane Malak is the main name behind Thrive Themes, and he is just so sincere and so straightforward and very matter of fact. Like you said, there's no hype. They are just there to deliver the goods, which is fabulous.
Creating great content and building your audience. This is ProBlogger.
But in saying all of that, there are some things that I don't like as well.
So you better tell us those.
I will tell you those. So I mentioned earlier that we started out with Thrive Content Builder, which was the previous iteration of their drag and drop editor, and they have made amazing improvements to Thrive Architect. But some of the old designs that I created didn't migrate as seamlessly to the new architect as I would have liked. So here and there, it sort of mucked up a few things. It stuffed up some of my testimonials on an event sales page that we had, and I lost a bit of content, and I'm just like, ah, damn. So there were some things that didn't go quite as smoothly there, and I could see there were a lot of frustrations about that. But look, kudos to them. They're really focused on the new functionality and the new features, and I think those far outweigh a few niggles here and there. I guess it just would have been nice if they migrated over a bit more seamlessly. I mentioned drip before. Now this probably isn't so much a Thrive issue, but if somebody unsubscribes to you on drip, then you can't reactivate them unless they actually resubscribe via a drip form. So that means you can't use the API with Thrive because it doesn't recognize the information being passed through as coming through a drip form, which is why we have to use the HTML connection to do that. So we just take the HTML code from the drip form, feed that into Thrive, and then drip goes, oh, yep, you've actually reactivated your subscription. Right. If we use the API and somebody has, say, unsubscribed from one thing, which has actually unsubscribed them from everything, or we have indicated them as an inactive person and actually unsubscribed them ourselves, they don't resubscribe. So we'll see them back in drip and we'll see that there's been activity, but they won't actually be sent any broadcast emails. Only transactional emails from drip because technically they're still unsubscribed. So that's just a bit of a niggle. I'm hoping things will get better with that because API connections do make things just a lot quicker. It's just a few more steps to do. It's not hard at all. It would just be nicer to be able to do a quick, easy connection for those sorts of things.
Sure.
With Thrive leads, I've had a few instances when I have been doing the A-B testing where it looks like the impressions of a form in the A-B test don't look equitable, so they'll be sending a lot more traffic to one than the other. And that's something that I really need to dig down and find out a bit more about. But the conversion numbers actually tell enough of a story to choose a winner anyway, the actual number of people who are converting on each form. But there's just a few little glitches like that I would like to get to the bottom of. But generally, it hasn't hurt me being able to make a decision on what's working and what isn't. It just seems a bit odd. And I really wish that you could duplicate lead groups. So when I said before that you might have a group of two or three pop-up forms that come up on a page at different times, if you're wanting to prioritize some content receiving forms over another, you kind of have to duplicate those forms again if you want them to still show. But you can't actually duplicate lead groups. So you actually have to save everything as a template and recreate each form in the group when you create a new lead group. And I would just love if you could just go duplicate and get a new lead form, a new lead group. But I kind of understand why as well, because you do actually have to change the settings of how each of those forms show and where they show as well. So,
So one big question I know a lot of our beginner listeners will be thinking about is the learning curve on this. I was talking to one blogger recently who signed up for a similar tool to this, I won't say which one, and they ended up having to hire a consultant to set up their landing pages using that tool, which kind of defeats the purpose in my mind of having a tool like this. But would you say there's much of a learning curve for this, and do you need that technical kind of background to be able to run it and put it all together?
Look, I think it's really easy. It is very intuitive. And like, for example, Thrive Architect does just make you feel like an architect. Like everything's just simple drag, drop, tweak here, there. You go directly to where you want something to be changed and you can change it. The thing that took me the longest to grasp is how lead groups work in Thrive Leads. I just wasn't quite sure about the whole sort of hierarchy and which one was served first and how you have to drag that to the top, and then you have to duplicate certain things if you want them to show in the next group. And so that was a little bit tricky for me to pick up, but if I was actually patient enough to watch all the videos in the first place, it's all explained. So even if there are things that you're not quite sure about, their videos are awesome. And like I said, Shane Malark is really clear in how he teaches you about how things work. And again, the knowledge base is there as a backup as well. I guess, I don't know if I want to say, they don't suffer fools gladly in that, you know, just do your homework first, read first. All of the information is there. They don't sort of go out of their way to go, oh, I'm really sorry that you couldn't figure out how to do that. It's, you know, this is how it works. This is what you need to go and do this. So again, their manner is pretty matter of fact and that sort of stuff. But do you know what? It's so straightforward. I haven't found it that difficult at all. And like you said, you did it yourself. So.
And if I can, anyone can, believe me. So I guess the big question that a lot of people will be thinking about at this point is, it sounds great, but what is this going to cost me? We kind of alluded to the fact that you've got the two options to either buy individual plugins one-off or sign up for the membership. Do you want to run us through the model that they've got for pricing?
Yeah, sure. So you can buy each of the plugins as a license for your site, and you can either do a single site license, or if you've got more than one site that you want to use on it, or you might have more than one install for your blog, then you can get 5 license packs, 15 license packs as well. And then you can actually access all of the plugins through the membership, but individually the plugins are priced differently. So, for example, Thrive Leads is $67 for a single site license. You get all the features that you need within that, and free updates and a year of support. So the only thing that you don't get after a year is that support. If you want to continue your support, you can upgrade to a membership, or if you just buy one of their other products, then you get another year of support for the new product as well as the one that you have. That's $67 for Thrive Leads. Thrive Architect is also $67. So again, super value for all the things that you're able to do with that. Ovation is cheaper. It's just $39. And, you know, just to save you from diving into your emails and asking people for testimonials and copying and pasting into things, I think is amazing value in and of itself. Ultimatum's a bit more expensive. It's $97, but just when you think about that, realize that that's actually a really conversion focused, you know, helping to promote something to get people to, you know, purchase something from you. So I would say that you would get your money back on that one pretty quickly. Or you can get everything. So most of them are around about that price, you know, $39, $67, $97, or you can get everything for $19 per month with a Thrive membership. So that works out to be $228 per year. So you buy it either on an annual basis, or you buy it, I think you can do a quarterly. You can do it if you pay quarterly as well. You just pay a little bit more. But obviously, if you pay annually, it works out at $19 a month, which is $228 a year for all of their stuff, including all of their themes. It's pretty incredible.
Mm-hmm. And I think individually they're great prices as well. So that may be the starting point for a lot of our listeners, I would suspect. You know, $67, that's a one-off and unlimited updates. A lot of the tools that I see around, even just for Thrive Leads, the equivalent of that, you'd be paying a monthly fee forever to use it. Whereas, you know, $67 is pretty amazing.
It is. It really is. Yeah. So I think, you know, even if you just want to start playing around with one or two of their plugins, you can just buy them outright for such a low amount. And if you just love it, you can just upgrade to your membership. And like I said, I've really enjoyed having access to the membership just for – it's all the different stuff that I'm learning as well through those emails and the knowledge base, and just knowing that I've got access to Thrive University to make improvements to what we're doing as well. Yeah, I think it's great. And, you know, you can use, when you've got the membership, you can use on up to 25 of your sites, which some people might think, oh, that's so many. But for us, one site has multiple installs. So between Digital Photography School and ProBlogger, we have about 8 or 9 different WordPress installs across a few different servers. So it can add up pretty quickly. And if you were to be paying for like multiple licenses for different plugins and everything, it actually doesn't take long before you just think it's so much cheaper just to do the membership. So
So I guess, you know, this is the type of thing that is going to pay for itself. You're not needing to pay a designer. You're reducing your developer costs. We've already seen that we're calling on our developer less because we've got able to create our own landing pages. And, you know, it has the potential to really increase the amount of email subscribers you get, but also the way you're able to convert them using a tool like Ultimatum is pretty amazing as well. So hopefully you can see, listeners, the type of tool that this is and how it could be useful for you. If you want to finish off, Lainey, by just telling us, who do you think this is ideal for? You know, is this for a real beginner, or would you say this is more of an intermediate advanced tool? Who should be considering this sort of suite of tools?
I think for a beginner, you might choose one or two of the things to have a play around with. So I think the Thrive themes to me look pretty good. You might not get as much flexibility in terms of the different types of styles and all that sort of thing you might like. And I know when you're a new blogger, it's very exciting to choose a theme and they don't give you much choice. But if you're not confident in being able to make changes to a theme, these are so user-friendly in terms of their drag and drop and everything like that. Thrive Leads, I think, yes, just do it. as a beginner, I think it's great because it just gives you that good basis to start with, and you're going to keep your site nice and clean because you're not going to be putting form code everywhere and trying to remember where it all is. So that one I would recommend to anybody. If you're at that level where, like I said earlier, you've established your content, you've got a bit of an idea of what your business model is going to be, and you're getting to that sort of that stage where every little improvement has a big impact, then it's worth investing in these sorts of tools. I'm really excited about Ultimatum. You know, because once that's cranking, it just has the potential for some really nice passive income as well, so that you're not always relying on broadcast sales and doing sort of big promotions to your email list. You can actually send somebody a targeted promotion based on what they're interested in at the time that they're interested in it. And that's a huge amount of customization available through a tool that costs $97. So I think there are solutions here for people at all different levels, depending on what you're trying to do, that just make things a lot faster for you. You're not having to invest so heavily in recreating the wheel with a developer. You're not creating a hard-coded solution that has to be updated, and that you've got this kind of legacy thing that you've built that you have to keep, you know, moving along with the times, when these guys are so focused on giving, I guess, you the best solution for any particular problem that you might be facing as a website or business owner, that just use their knowledge, you know, use their knowledge, and they package it up at such an affordable price that in some cases I think it's just silly not to.
What a great endorsement. I'm sure if they could pull that testimonial in and use it on their site, they would use their Ovation tool to do so, Lainey. As far as I can see, it doesn't have a podcast integration tool yet.
Oh, maybe I'll talk to them about that.
I'm sure that will come. Thanks so much for running us through that, Lainey. And if you are, as a listener, thinking about checking out Thrive, their suite of tools, head over to problogger.com/Thrive and check them out. I'd also love to hear in our Facebook group whether you do pick it up and which of the tools you're most excited about using as well. Thanks so much, Lainey. We'll have to get you back on to talk about Drip in the coming weeks, I think.
Oh, it's been my pleasure, and I really enjoy researching the different solutions that are going to make a difference for both ProBlogger and Digital Photography School, and if I can save somebody from doing all of the research that I have, then it's absolutely worth it.
Great. Thanks so much, Lainey.
Cheers, Darren.
This is ProBlogger.
Well, thanks so much to Lainey for giving us that time today. I hope you found that interesting. Again, you can find today's show notes over at problogger.com/podcast/233, where there are links to the tools and our courses as well. And you'll also find a full transcript of today's show, as we do with all of our podcasts. A couple of things to mention. We did mention episode there, 195, where Lainey and myself talked through using CoSchedule, another tool that has really revolutionized the way that we do our editorial calendar and a lot of our planning, particularly useful if you've got more than one person in your team and you're trying to coordinate the editorial responsibilities. And also check out our courses, our starter blog course, ProBlogger.com/starterblog. Those of you wanting to do 31 days to build a better blog, ProBlogger.com/31 days. And lastly, if you did want to check out Thrive Tools, using our affiliate link, you can do that with ProBlogger.com/Thrive. Thanks so much for listening today. It's been a long one. I hope you found it useful. I'd love to hear a little bit more about what you think about Thrive themes and the tools that they have. You can do that either on the show notes today or in our Facebook group. If you're already a part of that, if you're not already a part of the Facebook group, just do a search for ProBlogger Community on Facebook and you'll find our very active group there. Thanks for listening. Chat with you next week in episode 234.
You've been listening to ProBlogger. If you'd like to comment on any of today's topics or subscribe to the series, find us at ProBlogger.com/podcast. Tweet us at ProBlogger. Find us at facebook.com/ProBlogger or search ProBlogger on iTunes.
This episode of the ProBlogger podcast was edited by the team at Podcast Motor, who offer a great range of services, including helping you to set up and launch your podcast, as well as ongoing editing and production of the podcast that you produce. You can check them out at podcastmotor.com.